Good evening and welcome to Let's Play Resonance. This is a blind playthrough. This is another Wajidai Games point and click. I am on a point and click kick lately. These games are so much fun. I never really played these when I was younger. Maybe it's because I think they're more of a PC thing and I was strictly console gamer until my 20s. So I missed out on this kind of thing. Now these games aren't really that old, but I know that these, I understand that they're kind of like nostalgic throwback to your older kind of point and clicks. Which I really need to play some of those too, because these are tons of fun. So, let's jump right in here. I'm not really sure the premise on this one, but it doesn't matter. I'm fairly confident it's going to be awesome.
Confirmed reports now coming in from Zurich, bringing the total number of countries experiencing attacks over the last hour up to 12. And we're still waiting for word from our Washington bureau, since losing contact with them approximately 20 minutes ago. Explosions or some type of attacks have occurred in cities around the globe. The attacks are accompanied by power surges, large-scale blackouts. At this time, we do not know the exact nature of these attacks,
but they do not appear to be conventional explosives.
Some have pointed out, and this is still just speculation, these attacks appear to resemble the incident that took place at the Juno Particle Accelerator in Aventine City on Sunday morning. Though authorities have been calling that an accident. What connection the incident in Aventine City could have had to these worldwide attacks is, at this point, unknown. Being told now we've established...
Oh, back up 60 hours. Classy apartment.
Ooh,
I like the water stains in the corner here. This is nice.
That sound. Make it stop. Where is that noise coming from? Well,
probably your phone, right? Or is that your alarm? Is it your alarm? That's a really weird alarm tone. That was the cheapest alarm clock on the shelf at this store. Yeah, that's the kind of thing I'd get too. Normally pink isn't my color, but who's gonna see it? It's a fair point. Well, sound is not coming from my alarm clock. I definitely recognize that awful sound. Besides, I don't set my alarm on Sundays. Oh, alright. That was the cheapest hamper I could find at the shop and save. I have a feeling we're going to see a lot of the cheapest things available. Sound is louder over here. Oh, it's probably your phone in, like, your pants pocket. Nothing but a dirty pair of pants and some socks. Yeah, check your pants pocket. But I swear the sound just got even louder. First, though, we're going to look around a bit. I'm not going to miss this bed when I leave here. Do you have plans to leave here? Ooh, thank God I won't be here much longer. Why is that? Can't stand these things. Computers? I only use them when I need a complicated simulation or a brute force solution. Computer-generated results just lack the finesse of an elegant mathematical proof. Pfft, whatever. I prefer computers, but sometimes they're necessary. Is he just gonna say, this isn't the source of the sound? Yep, beeping is not coming from the computer. It's still happily crunching away at the particle physics simulation I wrote. Well, that bathroom is so filthy I sometimes feel dirtier coming out of the shower than I did going in. I'll be so happy when I can get out of this place. No beeping here. Sound doesn't seem to be coming from the bathroom. It's just the usual symphony of leaky faucets and rattling pipes. I know the phone's kind of annoying, but I'm figuring we're going to be sucked into a conversation when we answer it, and I want to look around at everything first. It's just a light switch. Unremarkable, except for how remarkably useless it is. What, is it broken? If the light worked, it might help me find the source of that noise. It is indeed broken. Oh. Ah, classy. Fortunately, it hasn't worked since last night. Well? Call your landlord. Better buy a new bulb by tonight, or I'll be doing my work on the floor by refrigerator light again. Really? I don't think my knees could take another night of that. I've never sunk so low and desperate that I've had to do anything by refrigerator light. I could just get a light bulb. My neighbor loaned me that tripod. He's really into photography. I told him that I was trying to get into it, too. Really nice guy, actually. Yeah, that was pretty cool of him. Little point in lugging that old thing around right now. I use these drawers to store some electronics and other items I need for my work. Such as? Drawer's locked. Now where did I leave that key? In the cabinet? The cabinet came with the apartment. That's kind of nice. So did the dead rat inside of it. Well, that not so much. There's nothing in here that could be making that sound. The smell is almost as irritating. Don't tell me you left the rat in there. Masking tape? There's masking tape on the floor where I was working last night. I don't want to move that. This just came down and gave me a 1. What's that about? Those are the equations I was working on all last night for Dr. Morales. It's really hard to do math while kneeling in front of a refrigerator for light. But at least I managed to confirm our theory. Okay. Finished those equations last night. Pick them up. Should hold on to the page with the results. Ooh, got some notes. Microwave. Picked up that microwave on the cheap. But I should have bought one big enough for an adult-sized meal. I'll just microwave things one at a time, I guess. Nice broken sink. That old thing is drier than the Sahara. Doesn't have any water, but it's got plenty of rust. So, if I ever need some, I know where to look. Is this possibly a hint to a puzzle to come? And a mini-fridge. This is our kitchen, huh? Not sure why I bought a mini-fridge. I usually eat everything the same day I buy it. But I'm glad I did. I needed the light last night. Oh, do mini-fridges have lights? Doesn't seem to be the fridge making that noise. In fact, on this side of the apartment, the sound isn't very loud. Must be coming from the other end. I know. He added a few extra locks to the door. And, you know, just a couple. You can never be too careful in Aventine City. Oh, and this is where it starts. Aventine City, the event. Sound doesn't seem to be coming from outside the door. Actually, it doesn't seem to be coming from this side of the room at all. Pretty sure it's coming from the bedroom. Yeah, I know, guy. We're exploring. Alright. Let's go get your phone. Pick up your pants. Those are the pants I wore last night. Knees are almost worn out from all the work I was doing on the floor. I think the sound's coming from my pants. It was my cell phone, and it is someone who is very persistent. I must have left it in there when I took them off last night. Guess I didn't recognize the ring. I don't exactly get a lot of calls. Damn it. And the battery is dead. Great way to start a Sunday morning. I've got a spare battery in my drawer. It should still be charged. You keep a whole spare battery? I just plug my phone into the charger when it needs to be charged. Anything else in here? There's some dirty clothes in here. Nothing worth digging through. Okay, let's also... What have we got here? Oh, left-click on an item to interact with it. Oh, I know that. Oh, what is this? Alright, my note. I do want to look at my notes. Results were right in line with Dr. Morales' theories. Just perfect. They're finished. I don't need to work with them anymore. Just hold on to them until I need them. And the phone is dead. I've got a spare battery in my drawer. It won't work if the battery's dead, so quit messing with it. Alright. But we need to find our key before we can get in the drawer. Don't really go in there unless I really have to. Oh. And even then, I might opt for the convenience mart down the block. Okay, so your bathroom's disgusting. Where do we think you've put your key? Cabinet? Oh god, it still smells in there. Nope. Well, he doesn't really have a lot of places to hide things. Oh wait. There it is. It's my drawer key! Shouldn't be leaving this just lying around. You really shouldn't. It would not take a robber long to figure out what it's the key to. You don't have that many things for them to try it on. Key. This is the key to the drawer where I keep my electronics. There's some important stuff in there. Like a battery for the phone. So, let's actually use the key. Choose an inventory item and something in the room. Drag the item out of your inventory. Drop it on the target. I can handle that. Come here, you. There we go. Unlocked. Easy peasy. There's my spare battery. Alright. It's a spare battery for my prepaid phone. Should still have some charge. Let's combine. I'll just swap out the battery. That did it. Excellent. So. Well, is there anything else in the drawers? Got a bunch of electronics stashed in here. I don't need any of them. Yet. Alright then, let's take a look at this phone. It's just the cheapest prepaid phone I could get. I don't get a lot of calls, so I didn't need any bells and whistles. Alright. Who should I call? Well, check the caller ID. Last call here is from a local number. Wait, that's the number for the lab. It's probably Dr. Morales. What's he doing there so early? Well, we could... Let's look at the address book, too. Who we got here? There's only one number in my address book. 14A. Pretty sure the call couldn't have come from there, though. Why? Who's at 14A? Nothing, just as I thought. Well, who was it? Oh, I right-clicked. I thought he would maybe say whose number it was. Well. Alright, let's call Dr. Morales. Better find out what's up.
Hello?
Dr. Morales, did, you just call me?
Eddings?
Ed. Yeah, it's me.
Is that Abe Goldfarb again?
Good. Listen, I need your help with something.
Now? It's like 6:30 in the morning. On a Sunday.
Oh, that is really early. And a weird day to be in the lab.
I didn't wake you up, did I?
Well, you did, but... I don't know. I don't really want to say no, because he did. I don't want to say yes, because I'm afraid it's going to be an accusatory, yeah, you woke me up. If I ignore the question, are we ignoring it rudely, or are we just evading?
Don't worry about it.
There we go.
What do you need my help with?
Direct and to the point as usual, I see. First, I need you to confirm something. Did you finish those equations I gave you on Friday?
I did.
Yeah, just last night, actually.
Good. Do you have the results?
Mm-hmm. The dialogue box is open. You can left click any item from your inventory. Just left it as a topic of conversation. Oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
Got them right here.
How close were our estimates?
Perfect.
Spot on. There's definitely an inverse relationship between attraction and proximity. Dr. Morales, you still with me?
I'm here.
It's truly astonishing, and wait until you see my proof. You were right all along. This is a vindication of...
I'm going to destroy them.
Huh?
Them?
My research, the data, the results.
Why?
I'm destroying it all.
But resonance, it's your life's work. You can't just...
I've been here all weekend thinking about it. This isn't a scientific or a mathematical dilemma. It's an ethical one.
Uh-huh.
And trust me, I much prefer my problems to be hypothesized, tested, and quantified.
You're wrong. It is math. Everything is.
No.
The potential for good far outweighs the possibility of misuse. You can't deprive the world of such...
Danger? Someone's been following me, Eddings. I know it.
Just please, don't destroy anything yet. I'll come in right now. I'm on my way. Wait for me.
If the guy in charge says we should destroy it, I think we should just trust him. Alright, we got a whole bunch of clock. Wait. Do I get to pick one? 6:55. 7:30. Just before 7:30, 7:05. That's kind of cool. Let's do things in chronological order. Next stop,
Imperiali Plaza. Please stand clear of the doors.
Obviously, we gotta help her out and give her back what she dropped. Come on, Ed. It's now or never. Oh, what? Do we see her frequently? Talk to her. First, I can't believe that piece of crap ever got a sequel, let alone a third movie. sure the producers are pretending that it was intended to be a trilogy all along. What is it? Better just leave it alone. I can't quite see it. Smelly, drunk, and asleep. It's the American dream. We better leave him be. Papers all over the floor. Reminds me of home. He doesn't want to pick it up. Like everything else in this city, the subway doors are covered in graffiti. Alright, let's take a look at this coin. There's a coin on the floor. It's not mine. I wonder if she dropped it. She did indeed. Alright, let's have a look at it. I'm gonna use an inventory item on a room object. So probably like on her. Hey, it's a peso. Excuse me, ma'am. Anna. Okay, well, let's take a look at Anna, actually. She's got her nose buried in a notebook. Come on, Ed, think of common ground. You like reading too, right? Yeah, but the thing though is if someone is reading, that's really not a good time to strike up a conversation with them. Like, they're reading. It's a solitary, engrossing activity. Don't interrupt. We're gonna interrupt.
Excuse me?
This is a fairly legitimate
reason. I am really busy. I don't want to be rude, but I've got to read these reports for work.
Oh, it's just that... Did you drop this?
Oh my god.
Scooch a little closer.
Thank you so much. I can't believe I dropped it. If you hadn't picked it up, I...
It's more than just a regular coin?
Yeah, it's pretty special to her,
you could say that. Look, sorry I tried to brush you off there. It's just... You run into a lot of creeps on the subway, and...
Right, I understand. It's special, then? The coin?
I guess it's kind of my lucky charm.
Tell me about
it. It's kept me out of trouble for almost 20 years, so I guess that's something.
Your lucky coin, huh? So... 20 years, eh?
20 years? You kept a coin for that long?
Yeah, I guess I just got kind of attached to it.
No, I mean, I would have lost it ages ago. I lost a car once.
How does one lose a car?
Yeah.
Long story. I'm too absent-minded. That coin wouldn't last a week in my pocket. Especially if I kept taking it out and fiddling with it like you do.
I do that?
Oh, what I meant was, you know, I see you on this train almost every day, and I just happened to notice. I promise I'm not like a stalker or anything.
That's
a good way
to make someone nervous.
You're right, though, I do fiddle with it, don't I?
Yeah.
Well, I would have lost it today if you hadn't picked it up for me. I guess I really lucked out this time.
I'm glad I could help.
So, what's the story behind the coin?
Where'd you get the coin?
Well...
I don't want to be pushy, but she could be holding back because maybe she thinks the story will... just isn't that interesting or something, or will bore us? I don't know, this is kind of a tricky situation here. Because obviously she's used to creeps on the subway, and I think it seems pretty clear that she brings along reading material intentionally to keep people from talking to her. So far, our conversation's gone pleasantly. Alright, in real life, I'd leave it be, because it's rude to press, and I'd just let her enjoy her day. But this is a game, and I want to know better.
Come on, spill it.
It was,
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's fine.
Probably too personal to share with some weird guy you just met on the subway. I should just stop talking, shouldn't I?
No, I appreciate the conversation.
Really?
The coin is just something I'd rather not talk about.
Maybe it belongs to someone who's died. You can use an inventory item. I don't think I have anything to... Yeah, I got nothing. So what does this mean? Yeah, I don't think she wants to hear about that. She really doesn't. And she doesn't want to talk about the coin. That's all we got.
That's your stop coming up, isn't it?
I thought you said you weren't a stalker?
Yeah.
I'm not. I just noticed.
Yes, I'm off at the next stop.
Next stop, Aventine Central Hospital. Will you stand clear of the door?
Oh, maybe she's a doctor or a nurse.
I guess I'll see you around. Thanks again.
No problem. I'm Ed.
Anna.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Alright, that went pretty okay. I mean, we did come off sounding a bit stalkery, but she appears charmed by it.
The doors will now close. Please stand clear of the doors.
I mean, Ed did seem earnest, at least. That went well.
Just you and me now.
Well. He doesn't want to wander around. I mean, it makes sense. You don't want to stand up and wander around when the subway's moving. What the? Oh, that would freak me right out. What's going on? No, not good. I think I would panic if I were on the subway and it just... something like that happened. Some kind of power surge? I'm kind of terrified for him, just imagining if I were actually in that situation. Thank God for emergency brakes and lights. You're trapped in the tunnels deep underneath the ground. In the dark. In this closed, confined area. That would be terrifying. I'm thinking peeling a poster off the wall is going to help me. It's really not. We should probably let this guy sleep through it, but... we're going to wake him up.
Sir? Wake up. There's been some problem with the train. Hello?
Nope, he is out. Yes, he'll be fine until help arrives. Yeah, this might actually be better, really. Because if he's a panicker... in fact, he probably won't even notice. If he were like me and he panicked if he woke up, then that might make things worse, so... we'll just leave him be. Papers on the floor. Alright, well, that's the end this way. I mean, I guess it wouldn't be too bad if you had people you know with you, but if it's, like, you in a mostly empty car, and it just stops, and it's dark, and... oh, there's no way. Well, I should find a way through those doors. Might be able to force them open. I mean, is that really a good idea? It seems like maybe the smartest thing is to just sit and wait for help. Well, that's as far as I can force it. Not nearly wide enough to fit through. Okay, well, we gotta find something, or... do we have our phone anywhere? What's this? I'm me? Can I be other people? Oh, that's pretty cool. Alright, then.
I'm going to destroy them. My research and destroy.
But resonance, the potential for good, you can't
danger, someone's been
Oh, that's kind of cool. I can see my conversations again. Alright. I usually end up standing on the subway, holding on to one of these poles for dear one of these for dear life. Riding the subway is much nicer on Sundays, when the car isn't overcrowded. Well, see if you can wrestle the broken one free. It's fairly solid. I don't think I'm going to be able to pull it out. Oh, but the loose bar. One of the bars has been bent. Looks loose. That could be a safety hazard. Or a way out of here. This might come in handy. So yeah, if this were a real-life scenario, I would just huddle, vaguely terrified, on the train in the dark, and hold on to the hope that help would be coming when they realize the train's not showing up at its stops when it's supposed to. And probably, I would imagine, in a real subway, they're well enough maintained that someone would figure it out and come save us. But this is an adventure game, so we are going to pry our way loose. Come here, you. Drag and drop. There we go. Yeah, into the terrifying pitch black of the subway. It's pitch black out there, but I'm certainly not waiting around here until help finds us. Why not, man? Well, I mean, no, I guess he's got the impetus. He really does need to go talk to talk to Morales before he destroys his work, but...
Hey!
Let him stay here, Ed. Maybe he'll have severed up by the time help arrives. There goes nothing. This seems really dangerous. Okay. So that one's done. This one's next. Wait, this is earlier, isn't it? I'm getting all messed up. If I could read a clock. This is like 6-something, and that was... Oh, it's different people, that's why. He's coming. Who's coming? Gotta hide fast. Under the bed? Or get away? Keep my treasure in there. Mama said it'd be safe. It's dark under there. I don't like it. Those steps are getting louder. Go under the bed. I want to look at everything in the room, but... Didn't want to clean up, so I just pushed these things under the bed. It's just some junk. I don't need it now. None of it. Vent cover. Wait! I didn't lock the door. What is that? No! Yes, I could hide in there. But there's some screws on it. Can't move them with my hands, but if I had something thin and hard... What is that? No, he's here! What is this? This looks like maybe something, a coin? Okay, so we gotta do that again. What is that thing? Okay, so quickly, what do we got? Get in your treasures. There's a lock on the chest. No, that wasn't it. Must have written it down somewhere. It's strong enough to stop it. Lock the door. Something. Hope that slows him down. I drew these for Mama, but Papa doesn't want them in his room. Mama said I should keep them in here. Can't take the pictures down. No time for that. Oh my gosh, he's right there. He's gonna break in. Gotta hurry. It's dark and scary outside. Oh, it's scary inside too, kiddo. No, it's too high to jump. There's gotta be another way. Where do I find the numbers? When Mama got sick and was in the hospital, she gave me Senor Bear. He likes to play with me. Like Mama. Like she used to. Maybe he can help me. Maybe. Don't forget to examine... The bear's key? Wait! There's some writing on his tag. Okay, what do we got? 591. Okay. That bear winked at me. I think I got it. That's my treasure. I remember. I'll have these gifts. Okay. It's a jar full of coins. It's really heavy. Well, we need to go under the bed. And then we can use the coins to open the vent. It's no use. I can't move it. What am I gonna do with all these coins? I am going to open this vent. That's it. I know how to open the vent. But I can't do it with a jar. Well, take a coin out of the jar. maybe I could... Yes, a peso. Yeah, I think it might work. I think it's loose enough to... Alright, get in that vent quick, kiddo. He's here. Please open. Huh? Ooh. Oh, it was a crazy nightmare. Okay. So who was... Was that her father, and he's just a monster in her dreams? Because he seemed monstrous to child her? Aww. So, next we got 705. And this makes sense, because our bar had the different
Dawn
people.
In Aventine City. The sun's beams glide between the buildings like a man's strong fingers through a dame's hair. The sight made me realize just how long I've been out here. Some low-level cat burglar caught breaking into the computer chip factory uptown had named this post office as a contact point for his buyer. Normally, I'd say this wasn't the kind of lead that warranted an all-night stakeout, but the chief's dogged insistence that I drop this case pretty much guaranteed I was gonna follow it through. Why did she want me off this case so bad? Could the chief have some connection to this criminal organization?
Selfishness.
I had a lot of questions, and my gut was telling me exactly two things. One, that I was hungry. And two, that it was Reggie's turn to go get some donuts.
No. I got us those sandwiches a couple hours ago, remember?
Yeah, but you didn't get the donuts.
So, how did you get the chief to sign off on this stakeout?
Oh, right. About that. If anyone asks, we were patrolling the neighborhood around the arson all night.
I'm not gonna get reprimanded for this, am I?
Relax, Reg.
Sir!
That's just a guy waiting for the bus. Oh, no, he's going to the post office.
What are you doing?
That guy came from the alley. We don't have visibility down there. Which means, when he leaves, we're gonna lose him. I've got to get us a better line of sight.
How are you going to do that without them seeing you?
I don't know. I'll grow some eyes in the back of my head.
This is against regulations.
You're out of the military now, Reg. This is police work. Sometimes you gotta pick which orders you're gonna follow. And other times, you gotta make your own orders.
Detective Bennett.
Going radio silent.
Be careful.
Alright. There's a beat up old SUV in the garage. Don't need to commandeer a vehicle. One of the perks of being a detective is being able to sign cars out of the impound lot. Comes in useful for stakeouts, undercover situations, and dates. When you take a date in this classy old beater, huh? Can't leave. Gotta figure out where this hoodlum is headed. And to do that, I've gotta find a way to keep an eye on the alley without him noticing. Do you know for sure that guy's a hoodlum, though? He could just be a guy going to the post office. Spent plenty of time arresting vandals when I was a beat cop. Sometimes you gotta just appreciate the art. Sometimes I do. For some reason, it really amuses me. Near where I live in Michigan, there's a city called Ypsilanti, and on one of the buildings in there, someone spray-painted Ipsilicious, and I don't know why, but I really like that. So, not all graffiti is necessarily bad. There's trash all over the alley. Based on the smell, I don't think it's been collected in a couple weeks. Crumbling bricks. The foundation of that shop's in bad condition. There are crumbling bricks everywhere. Pick up a brick. You never know when a nice heavy chunk of brick is gonna come in handy. Alright, what about the trash? As a cop, I know I'm supposed to clean up the streets, but I ain't touching that. Besides, I can't see anything in there that might be useful. Fair point. Oh look, we got all kinds of stuff. Hitting something with a brick is my kind of problem solving. Boring, regular, empty wallet. Nowadays, it just holds my badge and my credit card. My trusty revolver. Doesn't look like that door's been opened in a while. Give it a try. Nope, locked. Somebody did a number on that fella. Got chopped up pretty good. Even if I needed a vehicle, I wouldn't take this one. Doesn't even have any wheels. Yeah, I see the cinder blocks. Okay. Oh, we can't interact with this. So no smashing the window to hide out in this store, which would be a terrible thing to do. Yeah, we don't want to break anybody's window. Newspaper vendor, eh? Newspaper vendor with credit card slot. I can't believe print newspapers still exist. Personally, I don't trust journalists, no matter where they're writing their schlock. Get a paper. Online news site, The Abbott Post, claims to have evidence of Vice President Bruckman's struggle with mental illness. Just $3.25 to read more. Rumors and gossip. Reprinting a blog? Newspapers are trying harder and harder to stay relevant. Well, it could be useful to get one, though. Is your favorite celeb a neo-Nazi? We investigate totalitarian chic. Just $3.25 to read more. What else we got? Stock alert! The Aventine Solar predicts unprecedented returns for investors. Run, don't walk, to your broker and tell him to buy. Just $3.25 to read more. Unbelievable. What commonly used household item may be in immediate danger to you and your family? Just $3.25 to read more. Unbelievable. We'll go again. Stock alert. What the? One more try. Okay, we're just repeating now. We got them all. Selfish networks, huh? Looks like a cell phone shop. Business must not be going so well. Alright, there's the alley. I'm a subway man myself. At least the trains run on time. The wood seems pretty weathered. I'm not sure how long that bench would support my weight. Give it a shot. We could just sit here and wait for the guy, right? I think we're meant to go in the alley. Beach under asphalt. Post office? The Aventine City Post Office, only slightly more reliable than my air conditioner. This branch is supposed to be a drop point for a criminal organization. Nothing to say about Brothers Real Estate Wizards? I don't like the look of that door. Oh, he will go inside. I thought he might refuse. Alright, no time to think. Better go with my gut. Do I go in? Hold back. We could check out the alley. No, I'm not supposed to engage the target. Just watch him. Gotta make sure I see where he goes when he leaves. So sitting on the bench seems like the best idea. I don't know if that'll trigger it, though. We should probably scope out the alley. I'm gonna actually go ahead and wind the episode down here. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this. Come back, and next time we'll see... I'm wondering if it's even going to turn out that this is our guy. This could all be false alarm. We'll see. And then we'll see who our fourth person is. What's happening to them at, 7:30 or whatever time that was.